Hey guys, so Ross RC here. Just want to show off my impulse purchase that I bought a few days ago. You know, I was just thinking, the Ruckus, it's a longer wheelbase 1/10 truck compared to other 1/10 monster trucks out there. And my body is kind of beat up, so eventually I want to look for a replacement body. With a longer wheelbase, the only options I really have are the stock replacement body or bodies that are made for the Slash, which has the exact same wheelbase, 333 millimeters. But anyway, this guy actually has the same wheelbase as some of the bigger 1/8 scale truck, for example the Savage here. So there are a lot of body options that I can explore, but width is a problem. It's got a long wheelbase, but it's actually fairly narrow for the width. So got myself a little 12 millimeter hex extension here. I believe these are 25 millimeters. Let's see. About 25. I think I had a choice between 25 or 15. I'm not exactly sure. Like I said, it was an impulse buy. I didn't really measure or think about it too much. 25 seems like a good number. If I widen it just enough, but even as is, Savage body would fit. I think there's a slight issue there in the back. The wheel might be rubbing the wheel well. I know I'm not gonna use this body, but there are a lot of options for the truck here. Give you a little side profile here. So if I just widen it a little bit, and actually 25 millimeter might be a little bit too much. Right, it's gonna go on both sides. So this is gonna be like a 50 millimeter extension. The Ruckus, I just looked it up, is 348 millimeter in width. So with these two guys, it's gonna bring it to almost 400 millimeters. And now that I think about it, 50 millimeter extension would have been fine. But either way, let me keep this video running here and get to work here. But I guess that sucks. This does not fit through the hole here unless I drill it out. Damn. Well, that was quick. About other wheels here, does this fit? No, so what? You gotta drill this thing? Try these different wheels. Some short course wheels that fit. Got a Glamis Uno wheel here that fits. I am guessing this is probably 5 millimeter wide. Yep, 4.95 millimeter. So you need a 5 millimeter hole in order for this to fit. Bummer. I really don't want to drill this. It would look cool. It would make the truck a lot wider. Well, I guess let me think about it. See if I actually want to drill it. Feel like it, but I might have to. All right, sorry guys. I thought we'd share this with you, but it was a pretty quick fail there. Okay, hey guys. Since the last time I took a video, I started, or at least attempted to install these 12mm hex extension on my Ruckus. However, this little pin here is 5mm in diameter, and the center hole of the stock wheels are probably around 4, so it wouldn't fit through. Since then, I went out and bought some metrics drill bits, 1.5mm to 6.5. I believe these are 5mm. I measured that last time. So I'm gonna expand the hole a little bit so that these guys would fit. It's not like me to do something irreversible, but you know, since I already bought these guys, I might as well go over it. So, set the camera here. I'm gonna get to work. Got a 4.8 and a 5.5mm. Actually, that's good, because I was worried that if I drill a 5mm hole, it might be a little bit too loose. So I'm gonna start with a 4.8mm first. Go from there. Just to double check. Yeah, it's exactly 5mm. There's no spacer in there. I'm just curious. I think it's probably going to show 3.9 or 4.2. So yeah, it's a little tight. Just to show you, this thing won't fit through it at all. So, again, just to be sure, measure twice, cut once, 4.7, 4.8, good. All right, let's see. Just gonna shine some light into this just to make sure that I'm right on that middle here. Oh, what the? Didn't even have to. They even drill? I mean, barely cut any plastic off. Tiny piece of plastic off. And no, I gotta go with 5. Yeah. The 4.8 bit in there didn't really take off any plastic. Wonder if I need to go to 5.5, because so the way drill bit's supposed to work, maybe just a little bit on the low side. I'll go with the 5.5 then. 5.5mm drill bit for a 5mm hole. That time, took off some plastic. This came from the 5.5mm drill. Okay. Yep. It's perfect. It's maybe half a millimeter too big or something, but it's perfect. Before I install these, let me do both the back wheels first. Okay, but yeah, 5.5, perfect. Okay. By the way, I got these off of Amazon. 2-day shipping by Amazon Prime for $7.99. Not a bad deal at all, considering you get 13 sizes of little bits. I mean, I could have gotten a set much cheaper, on eBay, but you gotta wait 2-3 weeks for shipping from China. So, got something off here, got it quick, pay a couple extra bucks, no issue. Okay, now that's done. Move this guy over here. Extension here. This hex is pretty thin, so I'm gonna have to use a pliers to pull it off. Okay, good. It's pulled off. A little bit of comparison here. Pins clean, bearings clean. I think I took these off not too long ago. Okay. So there's the cross slot here. One of them is a little bit wider than the other. So that's a very good design. Depending on the length of your pins, either go to the direction that's a little bit longer to fit the stock pin, so it's great. Alright, these just came from the right one, actually it doesn't hurt to rotate it. Alright, grab the, still some plastic stuff there. Okay. Pin, need bigger hex. Nice. Alright, it's locking pin. Oh crap. 8mm didn't fit, so it's a 9mm hex locking pin, which I do have it somewhere. Yeah, it's 9mm. Don't tell me it's too short. I'll be very pissed. What the heck? Come on, man. I'm not so sure. I think that the stub axle might be too short. I can't tell if this is actually secure. Oh, actually, that was stupid. It wasn't 9mm, it was actually 8mm, which is weird. I had the other one I had was 8mm anyway. Oh good, that's sweet. Actually, before I do that, let me put the stock one back on just to see the offset that it creates. 25mm extension. Right. Actually, it doesn't look like, visually, it doesn't look like it's a big difference, but that's good. That's what I was trying to go for a little bit. It's Let's make it a little bit wider. Stuck here. Let me get rid of this. Okay, again, go to the longer side. Okay, good. Now, get it so that you can see how much the back wheel is wider than the front. Do a little bird's eye view here. It's good. Right, if you look at it, the inner wall of the wheel, sorry, the tire is actually pretty much aligned with the edge of the body. Now you get a little bit space there, which means should give you more body options. No, I had the bring that over here. I was trying to fit this body in there. Actually, you know, this is a slash Ford Raptor body, same wheel base. I don't think it's still gonna fit. I don't think it's gonna fit with a monster tire still, even with the really widened. Yeah, it's not gonna. It's not gonna help, because as soon as this compresses, it's gonna rub on the tire. So still not gonna fit a true slash short course bodies, but I think it will give you more options. For example, let me try this now. HPI Savages, Savage Bodies. Yep. With the, extension now, you can actually, well, these are the stock bodies, it's not going to rub anymore. Right, it's perfect. So, probably going to give you a little bit more body options. You can start looking into HPI's Savage Bodies, and let me just finish up the front, give you a complete look. Jesus. Okay, and pull the hacks off. Extension. That's weird. Been having a little bit of trouble of sliding this in. Yeah, maybe it's exactly 5 millimeter, both the step axle and the extension there. So try a different piece here, see if it's just a little bit of, yeah, crap. Gotta get it in there, come on. Just that fraction of a millimeter. Difference can stop you from putting this in. Jesus, come on, man. Try the other side first. You kidding me? What the?
Jeez, come on, man. Oh, I'm gonna have to. Damn it. Add a little bit of oil. Things were going great until this point. Ah, come on. Jesus. Now I can't even pull it back out. Nothing ever goes smooth, especially this hobby. I'm not exactly sure if adding a little bit of oil is gonna help. But at this point, what else can I do? Want to start shaving down the axle, boring this out more. Oh. I'm gonna go a little bit rough. So weights towards the back and always slides off my little car stand here. This is probably not a smart idea, but went in. Do not try this at home, guys. I'm not responsible for you breaking stuff and doing stuff that you can't undo. But here, worked for me here. Yeah, with just a fraction of a millimeter of manufacturing differences can cause things to not fit. Right now, I'm all. Got oil all over my hands. Thought it was gonna be a clean job when I bought the extension. Turned out, I just drove my wheels, gotta force things in. But anyway, now that's done. So I think I'm all set. Just before I go, I'm not an organized person, but I love using these little pouches here for spare parts.
or parts that you replace.
Well, in this hobby, you gotta be somewhat occupied. Organized, I meant. These little pins that came with the extension that I didn't use. This is actually a good habit of mine that I'm trying to keep doing. Took a little bit of a label and just label what it was. Ruckus. Axis. Alright, just a little bit of label and over the years I've bought so much crap. Well, it's hard to remember what parts are for what, so little thing like that goes a long way. And crap that I replace, just throw in the box. And back to this, right? I'm not sure if you can see, so much wider now. Clean my hand before I grab my camera. But now this looks more like a 1/8 scale truck with the extended width. Right, bring you up a bird's eye view. Bring you over here, just a little comparison with the Savage 1/8 scale. Wheel base is very close, I think 333 for the Ruckus and maybe 335 or 1 for the Savage. But now, as you can see, width wise, right, just as wide as the Ruckus now. I'm sorry, the Savage. Bring over here with the Armor Nero, brand new. I haven't even run it yet, bought it months ago and been doing some prep work on it. But the Nero looks to have a slightly longer wheelbase, but width wise actually it is also much wider than the Ruckus. But I'm happy with this. It looks great. I like the way it looks, the Ruckus, but it just kind of looked weird to me that it's so narrow, being a monster truck. Now with the little extension, looks great now. And again, it opens up with different body options. Put the Savage body on here. So you can see, and yeah, that's great. I mean, you can even put 1/8 scale tires on these, and it wouldn't look awkward. These speed treads are actually fairly large, but where's my stock Armor Nero tires actually would still look funky. And it's too heavy anyway, I probably wouldn't want to go that route. So there you have it, 25mm extension hex extension on the Ruckus. You do have to, it's not a direct drop, you do have to bore out the stock wheels a little bit. Stock wheels, the center hole measure to be 4.2mm, you know, the kit that I bought, with the extension kit that I bought, the locking pin was 5mm in diameter, so you do have to bore out the center hole a little bit so that the pin will fit through. I had to force it in a little bit. I guess the stub axle was 5mm, just like the extension holes, so they were pretty much a little bit tight, so I had to hammer that in a little bit, but once it went in, it's fine. Other than that, it's not
It's not a time-consuming job, so everyone should be able to do that. Anyway, so I'll try to run this guy and see if it handles a little bit better. It does tend to, it does have a high center of gravity, but it doesn't roll over as much, doesn't have a traction roll as much as other trucks because the steering is pretty sloppy. There's a lot of, yeah, you see there's a lot of slop here. So it doesn't actually turn sharp, but it's fine for a basher truck. But with the widened width, it should do a little bit better in terms of handling. So, all right, I'll try to go out and run this guy and see how it does. Thanks. Actually, just to be complete, just want to show you what it looks like from the inside.
Maybe. So you can see that. And locking pins look like. Okay, that's all.
Hey guys,
come on, Ruckus out here. I just finished installing the 25 millimeter hacks extension. So. 25 millimeter each side, so 5 centimeter extension. So the width has increased a little bit. As you can see, the gaps between the wheels and the body, right? It looks to me, it looks a lot better than before. It looks a little bit narrow before, and installing the extension will kind of give me a little bit more option on the bodies that I can use. Anyway, it should. The handling should improve a little bit now that the truck is wider. Still traction rolling over, but not as easy as before.
Definitely drives a little bit better. Oops. Oh, I didn't break anything, did I? Oh, still one piece. What do you think? I think definitely looks definitely think it looks better. Hang on a second, I gotta throw some trash here.
Oh, the squirrel is fat.
God. Fat pretty well.
What happened here? Lost a screw? Lost a screw. Oh. Damn it, I was just getting warmed up. Ah, man. I just ripped it right out. Hang on a second, I'm losing a piece here. I lost both screws, actually. Oh, wow, what the... Yeah, well, the RPM hub carrier didn't break. Just lost both the screws. Ah, man, I think it happened to me once, but it wasn't on both sides. So that tells me I get some longer screws, and that kind of sucks, man. I was just getting warmed up. Anyway, well, you saw the truck, you know, with the wider stands, it does drive a little bit better, in my opinion, and it does look better as well. So I gotta get this fixed up, and yeah, it's gonna be down for a few days. All right, thanks, guys.